Notion just launched some game-changing new updates that we're so excited to discuss with you all. There are some small quality of life updates as well as larger updates that we think will make a big impact in the way that we use Notion. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. So the first small improvement Notion has made is with the sidebar, and now if you go to your shared area here to the three dots, you can actually sort it by manual or last edited. You can choose how many you want to show in your sidebar, and you can move the section around. You can do the same in the private section. So if we go down here and go here, you can see the three options here as well. So this is really useful if you tend to have a lot of pages, can't find what you're looking for. Now this should make it easier to only see the important pages on the left-hand side. So this next update is about the floating table of contents. So in the past, you had to actually create a table of contents block where you could see your table of contents like this. But now if you actually hover to your right-hand side, you see this floating table of contents, which allows you to access your table of contents from anywhere on the page. And this is so intuitive and useful, and we highly recommend using this feature and making the most out of it. If you go to the top right-hand corner three dots, you can now toggle this on or off. So if you don't want it, you can always toggle it off. The next update Notion has made is with the URL link previews. And in the past, if you pasted in a link, it would just look like this. But now if you paste it in, you have the option to paste as mentioned, which pulls up the icon and just an overall better look to the links. So we highly recommend you to try this out when you paste in links onto your Notion pages. Next update that Notion has made is relating to Notion Calendar. So if you're in Notion Calendar and you want to schedule a focus time or out of office, you can simply add a new calendar entry here. And as long as you have a Google Workspace or school account, you'll be able to go and change this event type into either out of office or focus. So be sure to keep an eye on that if you have those kinds of school or work emails. So the next update we wanted to show you is that you can now pin tabs. So if you have two tabs in Notion, you can simply right-click one of them and then pin tab, and that's going to allow you to always have access to your pinned tab up top. The next update that Notion has made is that database views that are grouped by the select status, multi-select person or relation properties are loading faster. So if you have something like this where your database is grouped by a relation property, you might notice that the items are going to be loading faster for you. So the next update is that if you have a locked database, if you go to the top right hand corner and then turn on the lock, you can still add different filters by going to the filter here and adding what you need like this. The next update we wanted to discuss is the changes coming to the Plus plan. So if you're already in the Plus plan or were considering the Plus plan, be sure to check out this pricing change. And basically it's going to change like this. The reason seems to be that Notion is coming out with even more updates on things you can do with it. And mainly this is things like unlimited team spaces and website with custom domains and visual tools, and of course the automations. The next update is relating to Notion AI. And as far as we know, Notion never actually talked about what it was using to power its AI. And now it actually says that it's being powered in part by GPT-4. And what's really interesting now with this Notion AI now is that you can actually connect it to Slack, and further integrations are coming soon. So if you have Notion AI and you're inside of a Notion page, you can simply go to your Q&A here and you can actually target your searches, and you can also go to the three dots here and connect it with Slack. So basically what that means is that you no longer have to leave your Notion to search for things, but you can actually also search through your Slack channels. And this makes it such a nice all-in-one tool so that you don't have to actually leave your Notion. And finally, something that we're most excited about is the Notion Sites changes. So this is a huge game changer for Notion, because up to this point, Notion has been used as a web page, but it just didn't have all the features you might want when you want to publish a website. Now, if you have the Plus plan and you go to share and it's a shared web page, you can actually access something called site customization. So if you go to site customization, you have these options to choose the theme, whether it's light or dark mode, and you can choose the favicon, header, and Google Analytics. So if you wanted to add some pages to the navigation, you can also add those here. You can turn off breadcrumbs, you can turn off search, you can also turn off duplicate as template. And the duplicate as template is really important because if you are a template creator, you might not know where to actually turn this on or off. So this is really important. Or if you want to protect your privacy, you might want to turn this one off when you're sharing. So these are basically some huge changes that we think that Notion is going to probably continue to develop. And this is like a first step, and we're just so excited about the direction this is going. And if you've been wondering about publishing your website through Notion, this might be a great time to start doing that. So the final bonus tidbit that we just wanted to highlight really quickly is that coming soon, we think that there's going to be a huge update with the charts and dashboards. So if you see this Plus Plan update announcement here, it says coming soon, visualize data with unlimited charts and dashboards to track progress and goals. So before, we had to use third-party tools in order to show graphs of your habit tracker and so on. So we really hope that this is going to be a game-changing update that's coming soon. Thank you so much for watching. Let us know in the comments if you've already been using these updates and which has been your favorite. Feel free to let us know if you have any questions or comments, and we hope to see you all in the next video.